So Prince Harry is going to share the highs and lows of his life in a new memoir. It's set to be released late in the year, with all the proceeds of the book going to charity.
The Duke of Sussex has said he's excited for people to read a first-hand account of his life that's accurate and wholly truthful. Joining us now to discuss his royal biographer, Angela Levine, who is disappointed in Harry for doing this, TV presenter Trisha Goddard, who believes he's absolutely should be able to tell his story his way. Angela, I wonder, we've talked a lot over the last year about Prince Harry and the way their move to America has gone and revelations along the way with the series that... the interview that they did with Oprah Winfrey, of course, and the other various bits and pieces he's come out on his podcasts. What are your concerns about him telling his story in a biography like this that we haven't heard already?
Yeah, I think we will need to find out whether he's talking his truth, the truth, a new truth, because if you go back, for example, to 2017, when he was a guest editor on the Today programme on Radio 4, he was so full of praise for his father. He said, "When I was young, I thought you were wrong with the plastic and looking after the world. But now I realise that you were ahead of everyone and you've been fantastic, and I really listen and admire what you tell me." Well, I think his father is at the top of the list to smash yet again.
Well, we don't know that yet, though, Angela, do we? I mean, admittedly, we have heard him be critical on that podcast about some of the things he's been through. But maybe if he's writing it down and he's thinking it considerably with someone who's going to help him, it will be more balanced and he will be able to weigh up some of those things so he can credit his father with some of the positive stuff that he's experienced as his son.
Will Meghan let him? That's the answer to that one. The other thing is that I think that if it's going to be intimate, as he says, I feel he risks looking like a traitor to the royal family. I can't believe it's going to be all honey and sweetness. I think he's going to smash again. I don't know why. Does he want to destroy his family? Does he feel so revengeful that he has to take yet another knock after Oprah and after finding freedom? I don't quite get it, why he doesn't want to move on, enjoy his life. He's making pots of money. He's in love with his wife. He's got two children, a girl and a boy. But why is he so negative about his past? He can't leave it alone. It's like a cat, a dog tearing at something to destroy it.
Trisha, those are quite negative terms, that he's a traitor. And it's going to be destructive. I mean, the other argument, of course, Trisha, that you'll have heard, is that for somebody who wanted to be out of the media spotlight, he has thrust himself back into it. I mean, this book will generate headlines for months, years.
Yes, as it did with Edward VIII. Of course, he wrote his memoirs, you know, after he was quote-unquote exiled, which I guess Harry in many ways sees himself as doing that. Angela's got a very negative and, I think, somewhat simplistic view of what relationships are. You can absolutely love and adore somebody and criticise something about their past, as Prince Charles loved and adored his father, but also had criticised his family about their decision to send him to Gordonstone. So life's not just black and white. And we don't know yet. I mean, I would actually love to hear about his time in Afghanistan, for instance. He'll be talking about losing a mother at an early age. And we don't know that it's all going to be negative. And, you know, everybody's autobiography is their own truth. After all, Diana talked a lot, as we know now, in retrospect to Andrew Morton. He admitted that his main source for the book about Princess Diana was her. So it's been done before. And, you know, as Chicken Licken discovered, the world doesn't fall in. The Queen, can I just say, I really abhor the way people look at the Queen as some stupid little old lady who can't look after herself. This is a strong woman who's been through an abdication, her sister's death, her mother's death, all sorts of things. Prince Andrew and what he's going through. She has gone through and experienced so much. And what I admire about the Queen is she's got a wealth of knowledge and a wealth of experience. And she's continuously written off as some frail, silly old lady who has to be looked after. So I mean, I'm not saying it's going to be pleasant, but I don't think we can automatically say before, you know, anything's come out that it's all going to be about bashing his family. He's had a much broader life than that.
Mm. Well, Angela Levine, that's it's interesting, isn't it? Because depending on what perspective you are coming at this from, either this is another grenade thrown at the royal family, or they're an incredibly resilient institution which has weathered all sorts of things and will continue to do so, even if Prince Harry writes a book about his life.
Yes, I mean, the royal family is strong and has had to be strong. But I think I have a more negative view because I spent a lot of time with him in the year and a bit that I was with him for his biography, and I see a very different man. It's not based on just trying to be nasty. I fear he's turned a corner and he's just changed such a lot. I worry too, actually, that he will try to come for the Queen's celebrations in the summer and also get his daughter to come to Windsor to be baptised, because it will help promote the book. I've become very cynical about his aims and what he's trying to do now. I think he's giving a shock after shock, and I think he's probably enjoying it. It's up to him whether he wants to be like this, but he can't hang on to his royal titles and want certain things from the royal family and then give really very little in return, or feel he can be very open and wash all their dirty linen in public.
Trisha, yeah. It's interesting what that Angela was saying there, and the vast majority of our viewers that have got in touch this morning are sort of along her lines, that they find it very hard not to be cynical about why Harry's doing this. Although we were talking about this earlier, and one of our commentators and contributors said, look, right now, Harry isn't playing to the UK. He's left the UK behind. This is about the audience that he has, particularly on the other side of the Atlantic, in America.
He's hugely supportive.
Yeah, massive. And Noel, our correspondent, North American correspondent, said the reaction has been really positive in the States so far. And actually, are we missing that point of view, that actually he's not thinking about how it's going to be reacted to over here? He can deal with that. It's much more about his base in America now.
Absolutely. It is far more about his base in America. And he is loved. He and Meghan are loved here. And they still are smarting about a lot of the treatment they see Meghan having got. I think one of the very sad things and one of the biggest differences is that in the UK, you have certain publications who've been successfully sued. And that's where a lot of people are getting their news from. I'm not saying that those publications are lying, but personally, I prefer to get my information from someone who may not be seeing things through such bitter lenses. And you're absolutely right, Ben. He's playing to his US audience. He's made this his home. And, you know, let's wait and see. And I hear what Angela's saying. He's changed. We all change. And he's had a lot of therapy. And I think that's probably a lot of what this is about, the therapy that he's gone through and, you know, subsequent things that have happened. I'm surprised, actually, that he's writing a memoir so early because he's still relatively young.
Yeah.
In many ways, I wish he'd waited a little bit. But still, you know, he's got a right to talk.
And he's got a story to tell, Trisha. As you said, I will be absolutely fascinated. Would love to hear about his time in Afghanistan, in the armed forces, you know.
I bet Angela will be reading it too, won't
you,
Angela?
No question. We're going to have to leave it there because we've got some breaking news. But Trisha and Angela, good to have you with us this morning.